Hello everybody, and welcome back to my little tutorial about a new upcoming instrument, Rytmik 2. Today I want to give you some quick tips and tricks on how you can improve your workflow using Rytmik. The first thing I want to show you today are the different kind of possibilities you've got to bring a sound from Rytmik into your DAW. To support different approaches on how to do that, we split the keyboard sections in three different sections. We got the green keys, the yellow key and the red keys. With the green keys, you can play one shots. With the yellow key, you play the whole arrangement. And with the red keys, you can play each track individually. To avoid using the same loops over and over, or if you already created yourself a cool set of sounds, you can play them live using the green keys into your DAW. So let's try that out. So you see, it's very easy and hands-on. The next thing you can do if your loop needs to go on for a longer time is using the red keys. With the red keys, you can play each track individually. To do so, just draw on your MIDI notes and expand them to all the red keys you've got. And now you just simply duplicate your loops and erase or add different tracks. And there you got your variation. But if you want even more control over your MIDI files, you can use our new feature, the MIDI drag and drop. You can find it in the arrangement section. And there you go. You just drag it into your MIDI track. And there you got your MIDI files. So this way you can really go into detail. And now you don't have to use Rytmik anymore as a sequencer, but only as an engine where you get your sounds from. The next thing I want to show you is one of my favorite features from the new Rytmik update. It's called the random generator. You can find the random generator inside your mixer track. Just add a new track and there you find it. You can choose between four different options. You can randomize everything, you can randomize the sequencer only, you can randomize the sound only, or the miscellaneous features. Let's do it one after the other. If we start with the sequencer, you have to press the randomize feature and there you got your randomized sequence. If it's too weird, you can still quantize it on eighth notes or fourth notes, and it won't erase the original, so you can still go back. If you play it now, you won't hear anything because you got no sound selected. To do so and get inspired by something, you can choose the sound and randomize it. This is pretty cool because most of the sounds you probably won't create it yourself, but it's still very nice to get inspired by it. So let's play around for a while. If you found a sound you like, you can still randomize the sequencer and create new interesting patterns. If you want even more variation in your sound, you can go on and randomize the miscellaneous features. With the miscellaneous, you will randomize the decay amount, the panorama, and if you got it activated, the drive and the tone. To do so, just put it on sequence that it will react to the table. For this example, I will bring up every single velocity event so you can hear the effect of the miscellaneous features better. So let's have a listen. So as you can hear, it can get very crazy, but it's still a nice method and will help you create your own individual sounds. The last thing I want to show you for today is how you can create interesting Modwheel automations inside of Rytmik 2. To do that, we created an own page, the FX page. You can find it on the right. There you can find 5 different slots, which you can fill with different kind of functions for your Modwheel. With the slot volume function, you can fade single tracks in and out. So for example, if I draw this line and activate my hit and my FX, you won't hear it anymore. And if I go back here, you can hear it. This is very useful if your loop needs to go on for a longer time. This way, you don't have to change your MIDI events, but instead just play around with the Modwheel. Furthermore, we've created an invert function. It will pop up if you activate the button above. This means that it will basically do the opposite of what you've drawn inside the table. So let's say we invert this function. You will hear the hi-hat only there, and not there anymore. The next thing I really like to do is to boost my tracks. So therefore we've created the compress function. With this function you got a really strong and powerful compressor to boost your tracks up. You just draw in the amount you want and turn up the input. And you will hear everything gets compressed instantly. If you want to boost your tracks even more, you can come down to this area and use our inbuilt transient designer. You can turn up the attack. So this really can make a difference. The last thing I want to show you for today is the variation function. You can find it over here. The variation function will vary the notes that get triggered, but doesn't change them inside the mixer track. So to hear that, you just draw in your line as you already learned, and then assign different slots to the variate function. So let's see what kind of difference it makes. So as you can hear, this is another very powerful feature to make your loops more organic and variate them over time. That's it for today. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to check out our other channels or visit us on cinematic-instruments.com. Thank you very much and have a nice day.